Hey guys, it's Lance at Mac Sound Solutions, and it has finally happened. Mac Pro, and I'm talking Mac Pro 2009 to 2012, running Opencore, can now safely update to Big Sur 11.6. We've been stuck at 11.2.3 because of some bug in Apple's system that did not affect new Macs, but it affect older Macs. I don't think it was a malicious, intentional thing. It just has to do with the new processors compared to the old processors. Anyway, they have found a workaround, and Martin Lowe, who puts together this special OpenCore package to make it really easy to install OpenCore on your Mac Pro, has updated it with the fix in that OpenCore package. And it is OpenCore 0.7.3 version 2. So our Mac Pros live to see another day, another year, whether it's going to work with the upcoming OS that's coming out. So far, people are running the beta and saying that's working, but there could be quirks that they have to figure out and fix. But this is an amazing thing because it really seemed like we were at a dead end, and we no longer are. We can be current on our 5.1 Mac Pros. And I'm going to show you how to do the quick OpenCore update. Okay, so once you download Martin Lowe's OpenCore package 0.7.3 version 2, very important that it's version 2, then you launch the Clover Configurator app and mount your EFI. Now, I already have OpenCore installed, so this is updating OpenCore. This is not installing OpenCore from scratch. So I'm going to go find my system drive, which is the Samsung there, and mount the partition. Now, I have it on my system drive. You don't have to have OpenCore on your system drive, but I have it on my system drive. So now you go to the EFI folder in Martin's package, right? So it's where Clover Configurator is. You see that EFI folder in there. And you also see the EFI disk mounted on my desktop over here on the right. So you open up the EFI that's on your desktop and Martin's folder called EFI, and you're going to copy over the boot and the OC folders into the EFI folder on your hard drive. And basically, you want to replace those two folders with the new versions. Again, this is updating OpenCore. This is not installing it from scratch. So we're copying over the files. It happens pretty quickly. And then that's it. You're done. So then you reboot back into Mac OS and you go to your system preferences and you go to system update, and you can now download 11.6 safely. Before, if you didn't have the latest version of OpenCore, your system would get corrupted. It would start slowly erasing or, you know, corrupting your hard drives upon every reboot. It might not do it the first time, but over time, it caused a lot of major issues. And this, by the community, got called the race condition, which was only happening to Macs that are not on Apple's list of Big Sur supported computers. The Mac Pro 5.1 last supported OS was Mojave, but thanks to OpenCore, we were able to run Big Sur 11.2.3, but that seemed to be the final OS update until a week or so ago when Syncretic fixed the issues with what he calls the SurPlus patch. And Martin Lowe then added it to his OpenCore package for the Mac Pro 5.1, 0.7.3 version 2. You can also edit your own config playlist, if you're into that sort of thing, in OpenCore and install the SurPlus patch yourself with older versions of OpenCore. So, as you can see, I have successfully updated to 11.6 on my Mac Pro 2009. That's pretty amazing. Now, one thing you got to note is that when you do the install of 11.6, it seemed to get stuck. The progress bar, after it downloaded, it then rebooted, it then started the install, and then it was stuck installing for quite some time. You know, maybe even like 15 minutes, it just did not move the bar whatsoever. It got like a third of the way there, and then it was just stuck. So I saw that some other people like rebooted their computer because they thought it was just locked up. But the truth is, just be patient, and it will eventually, you know, continue the install. For me, it was stuck there for quite a while, and then all of a sudden it just went boink, and it moved up further, and it completed. Then it rebooted again, did some more installing, and then it rebooted one more time. So I think it was three reboots, all done on its own, and I did not have to force shut it down. It just did the reboots as it was doing the install, and then bingo, I was able to log in. It optimized my system, and away I've been. And I've been on this for about a week now, and it's been very solid. And I'm using Final Cut, I'm using Pro Tools, I'm using all the apps that I always use. And the other big part of this is that now, because we're past 11.2.3 for us audio guys, we finally get to use the latest version of Apple Music and stream and download Lossless Audio and Dolby Atmos Audio, which is great. That was, to me, very sad that we could be stuck in a place where we never get to do that. For me, that's huge being an audio engineer. I get to listen to, you know, 24-bit, 48K, 96K masters on Apple Music. So that's awesome. So thumbs up to the Opencore crew, Martin Lowe, and the other guy. I'm going to put the links in my description, who fixed it. And if you're going to use this stuff, you should really donate to these guys, because these guys put in a huge amount of time and nobody's paying them to do it. And they have helped keep our Mac Pros present. So thumbs up to those guys. It's totally awesome. I would highly advise joining the Opencore Facebook group, and all the info you need is really located there. So just join it and get using Opencore and get your Mac Pro up to date. Again, it's mainly for the 2009 to the 2012 Mac Pros, the old cheese graters. So we're going to keep grating that cheese for another year, maybe, until they come out with a new Mac Pro Mini or a new Mac Mini with the M1X chip. Then I might move on to a modern Mac. But until then, I'm still rocking my Mac Pro 5.1. Okay, thanks for watching. Please subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you on the next Mac Sound Solutions video.